Oh, we can't use none of this? No, oh, fuck. This hurts. Oh, God. We haven't even started yet. I'm fucking dying over here.
All right, let's do this. You guys can never know what was the bit.
Jason's.
I'm killing you. I'm killing you. I'm sending you. I'm killing you straight up. Just bleep the whatever he said. Bleep the word he said.
I know.
I know. I'm sorry. I forgot I'm working with a professional. I'm gonna kill you. That one just cut us straight. Jacob's social security number is 514-357-231. You want to dox people?
Jason 00100467.
Airy.
Drop this whole IP address right there, baby.
Oh yeah.
I don't even know what the fucking IP address is, bro. I'm just talking shit. All right, let's
do this. If somebody read my IP address, I wouldn't know because I don't know it.
Exactly. Who the fuck knows their IP address? You just be like, boom, IP address. You scared, like, I don't know what the fuck that is.
Yeah, someone surprised me.
What are
that.
These numbers?
Yeah.
I don't know.
An IP address.
Okay.
I can't make a joke
out
of that.
What do you want me to suck your dick or something? Like, what about it?
What if the hacker leaks like a very, like a not an important thing? Like, your Disney Plus PIN code is 5143. Okay. You don't know the password to the account, though? No, I don't. I just know your PIN code. Oh, well.
All right.
Okay.
Cool. All right, let's do this shit, boys. Let's record. Who's opening this
episode?
We're already here.
Who was supposed to open?
Who's opening?
Isn't it Jacob this time?
Is it really?
Yeah. Okay, Jacob,
it
open.
It can't be.
We're like 5 minutes in. Jacob,
oh,
open.
Right. Oh, hey, guys. Oh,
hi!
Hey! We did it!
We did it?
We did it!
What did we do?
I don't know.
Then why'd you say we did it?
I don't know. We're
open
back.
Open the fucking.
Because it's the end of a Dora the Explorer episode, I guess.
We did it!
We snorted cocaine and we had some fun. We did it!
Yeah!
I think the worst part is I don't think this is the first Dora bit.
We said the N word on Twitter and got canceled.
We did it! Yeah! We found the imposter and he was still sus. We're fucking back. I hate this shit.
Yeah.
This is episode 95. You're so close to the episode 100 that we're not going to record because fuck you guys.
Fuck
I am joined here by the angry demon.
It's me. The angry demon.
we're also joined by Dora Connoisseur Super Gaming Dude.
Yes, I am in love with Boots the Monkey.
I was so scared you're gonna say Dora.
I'm not a pedophile.
Are you saying Boots is an adult?
Boots is a fucking monkey. Boots is a fucking monkey.
The way he talks, his voice is higher than Dora's, dude.
He's a fucking monkey. He is a fucking monkey. Shut the fuck up.
I don't know. It's a little.
Shut the fuck up. He is a fucking monkey.
Last but not least, we're also joined here by the illustrious
I'd hold those fucking boots up in the air as I pound his bussy. That's what I'd do.
What?
All right, comment of the day by some dude. He says, damn, what happened to my identity? Well, my friend, you just bought a house,
holy
a car,
shit.
And we opened 5 credit cards in your name. Thank you for
if
leaving.
Thank you so much.
Thank you for leaving your social security number.
If he could prove that's his number, all that stuff we bought is just his. So, what's the point?
We're keeping
not really.
It.
Yeah. Like, he's still thousands of dollars in debt.
Oh, yeah. That's his problem, not ours, obviously.
Yeah.
Well, I mean,
you know,
we're keeping the stuff.
I'm still the one driving the car.
Yeah, we're still keeping it. Like, that's
the one living in the house. What, is he going to go to California? No, he's in debt.
I wanted to say, and I've been thinking, I think it's clearly canonic. Wait, canon, sorry. I don't want to say canonic. Canon that we have just have a movie theater on the spaceship. We've used it more than once.
Yes.
And it's underground. So, yes, we have a...
It's directly under the recording room, so nobody can watch movies when we're taping.
We actually had to patch up the hole that we made in the floor as we fucking jumped through the floor in order to get down there. We had to patch it up yesterday.
Yeah,
it's all fixed.
Elevator would have taken the same amount of time.
It was
By
fun.
By the way,
though.
I don't understand why you made that hole, Larry. Like,
you fell through it too.
I was excited. Okay,
I was too.
The adrenaline was pumping. I was horny as always, but like we have to make that hole.
Yeah, isn't it fun that we cannot talk about it because I want to go in it blind?
We could talk about it.
No, we
just like ignore
cover your ears. Cover your ears.
I'm still gonna listen to it back to find highlights.
So Spider-Man, just do that, man.
No, I mean,
so Zendaya from that hit movie Dune was in Spider-Man 3, and him and Spider-Man got into some kooky adventures.
What are you talking about, man?
Have you seen Dune?
I have, actually.
Was it good?
What'd you think?
I wanted to watch it.
It was okay.
Where did you watch it on?
The movie theater.
Okay. I watched it on my phone.
What is that better?
As the director intended.
You, dude, you sounded so disappointed in yourself. So embarrassed. I watched it on my
director
phone.
Intended.
Yeah, actually, I watched it on my Tamagotchi. It's like no color, just squares.
I checked Twitter and the director, I was like, yeah, you better be watching this shit on the phone, motherfucker.
Oh, God.
I swear to God, if it's a Windows phone.
The director, like, he intended to watch, like, watch this in IMAX, you know, like, watch it, like, on a big screen. I'm like, no. I watched it on my iPod Nano.
Oh, no.
Is that the one without the screen, right?
That's the shuffle, but yeah.
Yeah, I put it on iPhone Shuffle, only the audio version. I'm just imagining shit, just like the book.
Yeah, like it's an audio book at that point.
Hell yeah.
Yeah, yeah, especially fight scenes where Corey's like, oh, oh, ah.
Fuck me, man.
Whoa, that was a nasty reverse kick. It's like the screenwriter shows up. That was not a reverse kick. That was some other kind of kick.
That was a triple axel, huh?
Triple axel.
It was a triple axel, Batman.
No, but we did it, guys. I did it, actually.
What did you do?
I got my bit stolen recently.
We made
got twice
it.
As many likes as I did. Yeah, I'm actually see y'all in LA because I got my bit stolen. So I'm scrolling my. I have a burner account. You know, I don't want to pollute my main. I use that for porn.
As always.
What was that? You just
he was looking up my follow list.
Oh my
no,
god!
No, I don't do that. I don't do that. I just don't want to pollute my main, and I don't want to pollute the group account too, because you know I have my goals.
Of course,
I have a little burner account on TikTok, and so I'm scrolling it. I have perfectly catered my For You page for exactly what I want, and I stumble upon this meme, and it says me watching Master Chief and Kakashi build the entire Taj Mahal after shooting at them once, and I think, this sounds oddly familiar. Now, I agree. I did not reference Master Chief nor Kakashi in my bit previously on the Cosmic Cast episode 93 with Jer, approximately minute 45. I don't know, maybe like 24. But I'm like, this, like, it's too much. Taj Mahal is like too much of a coincidence. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
Like, if he said like Twin Towers or Empire State Building, I would have let it slide. Mm-hmm. But Taj Mahal? Really? So I put on my little detective hat.
Of course.
I light up my cigarette. I say, beat it, toots. And I hit in his following list. Now, I was discouraged at first because his following list included 611 accounts.
Oh, my God.
Good Lord. But I do not give up. I'm scrolling. I'm looking for a particular set of colors. Blue, purple, and bright reds. And hints of beige. And as I'm scrolling down, I see some accounts I used to follow, some accounts I follow now. I see Lil Nas X. I'm like, okay, he respects the gay people. That's nice. Okay. And I stumble upon the epiphany. Deep into the 611 following list, I see it. I see the meteor. I see the space background. I see the misaligned middle line that I still haven't fixed of our podcast. It says Cosmic Cast. I'm like,
Interesting.
Now that's an awful coincidence. I log in the group account and I comment on his video. Nice joke, man. With a little smirking emoji. And I think that's it. I think he just liked it and that's about it.
He just like hides the comment like on Twitter.
Bro,
yeah, so,
you know, you could have just went on the group account and saw if he was following.
Yeah. Yeah, I just realized that. Yeah, that would have been taken so little time.
That's a good point.
Oh, yeah, I would have just looked up his account. It would have said follow back. Wow,
way.
Man.
Yeah.
I was carefully scrolling too. It took me like a solid 10 minutes to get to. Damn.
This nigga was analyzing every single profile picture.
I was clocked in like Lucy in that movie. Fucking five screens. They're all scrolling like eyes dashing. Chameleon eyes dashing left and right, non-synced eyes absorbing tons of information.
You watched Lucy. Is it called Lucy?
What's Carjo, yeah.
Damn. That was a good. I thought that was an interesting movie. It's not good, but it's interesting.
But it's bullshit.
Yeah, it's very
only
not
using
good.
10% of our brain. If we use 50, you can lift objects with your mind. If we use 100, you become omnipresent being.
You become a fucking god.
You become a god. Okay.
I thought it was right. I would like godly powers, that's for sure.
Man, it's pretty fun, yeah. I mean, the movie, not the godly powers. I mean, I wouldn't argue that.
Woo!
Yeah. Well, I'm God on the Discord server, so.
Yeah, but yeah, not cool, actually, man. You fucking loser.
Can you pull the moon by, like, throwing a lasso at it? Oh, God, a lot of movie references today.
Got an Owl City
reference. Wow, you're really going to be like that?
What?
What?
Bruce you're Almighty. Really going to taunt him with an Owl City lyric?
Oh.
Oh my god. Okay. Hey Austin, I heard that your boss discovered OnlyFans. Let's talk about that.
All right, let's talk about it. So something I think you guys will find this a little bit funnier than I did. So basically, my boss, you know, he likes to take like every single
No, I don't know him, Austin.
I said
let's get him on the podcast.
Episode 100, dream guest.
Let's go.
Says boss.
Okay, that would be kind of funny.
Oh my god.
Go ahead, buddy.
All right, so he takes like probably about an hour every day and just sits down
to
and watches
it. Porn?
Did you ever have heard him like our TikTok pop up on his shit?
It's possible.
Not yet.
It's so possible.
What if you just hear like Airbnb like, so that one time, and he just scrolls away.
Yes, that's what it would be.
Hey Austin, do you ever just hear like you're listening and it's like kind of quiet, and you ever just hear?
Leave Austin alone. Okay,
leave Austin alone, buddy. Do you ever say on the podcast that my cousin who doesn't really know about like my podcast or anything just like scrolled upon her feed, it's like that voice sounds familiar, and then realized it was our podcast.
That would be pretty crazy. Based
yeah,
anyway, Austin, keep going.
That was back when we were popping off. Yeah
I remember.
Keep going, buddy.
But anyways, okay, so yeah, he spends like an hour scrolling through TikTok almost every day. Now it's his business and he doesn't get a check from it, so I'm pretty sure he could do what he wants, but yeah, that's what he does. And the other day, he was scrolling through, and he happened upon, or am I going to say across? You guys vote.
You can do it.
What should I say?
Vote down in the comments.
Yeah, right now.
Yeah.
Let's choose across.
Pause the episode.
Let's have an interactive episode like Dora.
Imagine we really just stopped this conversation and moved on and waited for the next episode.
A pawn.
Or a cross.
A bike.
Oh no, Swiper stole the pawn. Swiper no swiping.
Swiper
no
took the fermented piss,
the piss jar. Yeah.
Swiper
you're
no
so funny.
Swiping.
I'm going to kill you in your sleep.
That's my cum, you dirty little fox.
Okay, stop.
Oh my god, Jacob, are you sure? You know what?
Are you sure what?
Austin, what happened to your boss?
Right. What happened to your boss, dog?
All right, so he's scrolling through and he finds this one video by a guy that you've probably seen. It's this guy that goes up to people and says, "Hey, nice car. What job do you work?" Have you seen that guy?
Yeah, obviously.
I haven't.
And
we should be on that.
He goes up to the guy in the video. He goes up to a girl and says, "Hey, nice car. Where do you work?" And she says, "Oh, I have an OnlyFans." And my boss, he puts down the phone. He looks at me and he says, "What's an OnlyFans?
I've heard of this before.
I just don't know what it is."
Ooga. You know?
Now, I could have just answered the question, but I figured this was such a rare opportunity to talk to someone.
My own. What's up, guys? My name is Austin, and I'm opening.
Okay.
But you don't have to. It doesn't have to be porn. You know, like you can just have brand.
I know
like,
that. I know. I'm gonna get to that. But no. But like, I could have just answered the question, you know, but I figured it's such a rare opportunity to come across someone who doesn't know about OnlyFans that I wanted to answer it a little bit differently, you know,
okay.
But I couldn't think of anything. So I instead said, I'm going to bleep out his name, but go ask is his 13-year-old son.
Oh, God.
And I wanted to see what he would say. Honestly, like, I just wanted to see what he would say because I'm sure he knows what it is.
And what did he say?
Well, he wasn't there, so my boss was like, he's not here, so I'm just going to look it up right now.
Oh,
okay, no. So he looks it up on Google. And wouldn't you know it, the description you see of the website on Google is like the most tame thing you can imagine. Like, it tries so hard to hide the fact that it's like 95% porn, right? It's like, OnlyFans is a content distribution service, a subscription-based distribution service where the subscribers pay a fee to the
creator. I once saw a girl on OnlyFans squirt her breast milk into a cup and drink it, and I'm still looking for that video.
Nigga was mesmerized.
You're a fucking menace, you know that?
I think he knows.
You're a fucking menace.
Not even a joke. You actually are, bro.
Like you guys like, get on my case for so many weird shit I say, but you're fucking awful,
honestly,
dude. Like,
no,
what the
honestly,
fuck is wrong with
I
you?
I don't think I needed to hear that. I don't think I needed to hear that.
No, I just...
Like, honestly...
This is why I don't feel bad for what I said. I say the shit I say because I'm not Jason.
I just wanted to show a juxtaposition of what Google thinks OnlyFans is and what it really is.
Yeah, but we both know that's sterile.
Yeah,
I actually got that.
I actually got that's what he was doing. You know, I was going to be like two sides of the internet and all, but really the two sides
yes,
of the internet
the two
are...
two genders of the internet.
Porn and
two gender,
kind of not porn.
Genders, you
porn and corporate.
Let's go.
But anyways, yeah. When he read that description, he was like, you know, he's always thinking about ways to promote the story. He's like, why can't we do that?
No fucking way.
He's like, why can't we have an OnlyFans? I'm not kidding. That's what he said.
No way.
Just pure, such a pure soul. He just, hey, what's up, guys? So we open our store.
He's not either.
OnlyFans.
He's not either. He's not a pure soul at all. He just doesn't know what it is.
No, but like pure soul concerning to OnlyFans. Like, what a king. He's just like, oh, well, let's check out this platform. What are other users can I befriend on this platform? Ooh, Curly Baby XO. I wonder, what's her content like? Oh, Lord.
Is that a titty? Oh, what's going on?
In a milk cup?
Really?
Oh, God.
Come on, a little callback here and there.
Yeah. I don't know. I think it was a bit too soon, but whatever.
Yeah, okay.
All right, moving on.
Damn. Okay, comedy. How about comedy controller? Damn.
I'm the comedy police, my dude.
Let's
anyways, all right. How about we talk about
can we not,
a football player beating his girlfriend?
Oh, God. Yeah. Such a I saw would... the video.
This is my other topic
for
this episode.
I truly think that was one of the worst ones I've ever seen in my life.
I couldn't finish it. It was like I watched.
I couldn't either.
I'm like, holy fuck.
I couldn't after the first and second slap. I was done. That shit was actually awful.
He threw her at a TV like, and he just kept beating her.
Like, what are you referring to? Sorry, I have to like step up.
There's
for a second.
A video of a football player just beating the shit out of his girlfriend.
Shit.
It's
crazy how this keeps happening. Why is it always football players?
Well, not always.
Oh, well, that's actually super interesting because, like, you know how NFL has been hiding that, like, there's brain trauma and, like, all that develop. I'm not excusing him by any means.
Mm-hmm.
But, like, see, that's how you know I'm chronically online. I'm not excusing
him.
Yeah.
Have,
no, but, like,
the
there's
fact
actually,
that you think
like,
you
medical research that's been hidden by the NFL that there's brain
concussions and
altering
CTE
trauma
and stuff
from playing football too much.
Mm-hmm.
One of
yeah,
like,
it's
any problems that the NFL has right now, but. Anyways, yeah,
there's
I want to talk
there's
about...
There's a whole, like, movie with Will Smith about it. It's really nice.
I know.
Really a movie episode, huh?
It was Pursuit of Happiness.
No, right? That's not
that's
that one.
That's not that one.
It was The Blind Side.
Okay. It was The Blind Side.
The Blind Side. That was a good movie, by the way.
Oh, wait, no, it's not.
Yeah, it was all right. But anyways...
It was iRobot?
I've never... I didn't see the
part.
I'm
Legend.
I didn't see that part of with the TV that you were talking about. I just saw it.
Yeah, he takes her and throws her into the TV like you know how you throw a controller into the TV when you're...
Why would you say that? Why would you say that? No, no,
no
you don't.
Stop.
You don't have to
no,
say
he literally
no.
does do that. He literally picks her up and just
he
chucks
does.
Her in the TV.
No,
man,
he does.
The TV
so
just
up.
Knocks
us. It's one of the saddest videos I've seen
it
like,
really
in a
is.
Minute.
It really is.
But like,
is.
I want to say a few things about this, all right?
Okay.
A few things that I think not as many people are talking about that they should be talking about.
Oh, my God!
Okay, man, come on. Stop watching.
I've never seen the full video, and I'm actually seeing it for... This is about to make me cry, bro. This is actually evil shit. That is evil.
Just turn it off. Turn it off.
But let me... Let me say a few things.
Go ahead.
Number one, all right? Apparently, she had just said to him that she was cheating on him. Now, I want to say a few things about that before you interject.
Okay.
Number one, she had a bunch of cameras set up, okay? So she was prepared. Mm-hmm. I think she might have been faking it.
I think she might have been faking
that she was cheating because she wanted to catch him doing this. And if so, then bravo for your sacrifice, for sure. But number two, if she actually was cheating, I'm not saying that's the right thing to do, but can you really blame her if this punk is like this? And number three, this all happened in front of their, like, 5-month-old
baby. Yeah, there's a child there, right? I just remember.
And I just want to be like, you know, there's going to be a bunch of kids that grow up like this and learn that that's what you do when you're angry with someone. Mm. You hit them. You hit them and you excuse it by saying you're standing your ground. No, punk, you are not standing your ground. You're colonizing someone else's.
Tell them.
Talk your talk, my nigga! Let's go!
Hey, talk your shit.
Somebody... Can I get an amen from the congregation today, man?
Amen, my brother.
I'm telling you, some of y'all need to wake up in this congregation today.
God damn.
You know what I'm saying? Nobody need to wake up, son. You know what I'm saying?
Wake up, sheeple.
Anyways.
Like, honestly, it's this shit's egregious. And like Austin said, I do agree with Austin where he said, I think she was faking the whole cheating thing because,
at least because, there's like, good evidence for it.
You wouldn't normally say that to someone who was an abuser, you know?
Imagine she got killed in the whole thing.
Oh, God.
Like that shit would...
It's that rough that she could have been killed. He literally fucking choke slams her into the fucking baby seat. Are you fucking kidding me?
Nah, man, it's...
Evil ass shit. This nigga deserves to be locked up and the key thrown away. Like, God fucking damn.
I was not well after that video. Like, there's like various few videos that, like, even like we're in this desensitized era that like
truly get you.
But this one was so
that one does.
Man. Wow.
It's just unadulterated violence. It's evil shit.
We're switching. Lighter.
Let's move on. Let's move on. Fuck domestic abusers. Let's go.
Episode 100, man. I got to rant about something. I've been on a quest, okay? Mm-hmm. I've been on a quest to find us the best guest. Nobody has reached back to me, okay? I can say this because they're certainly not getting back to me, okay?
Mm-hmm.
Reached out to... Well, it wasn't just me, but I'm just going to take all the credit. Who was working on this? Leafy, okay? I wanted to get Leafy on. Would be the most, like, the strongest surprise. Couldn't work. Mm-hmm. Fuck. Keemstar reached out to his management. Ignored us. Fuck. Mm-hmm. And, like, I offered to pay. That's the worst part. You know, like, reached out to Goka fucking Naru. Okay? Quiet.
That would have been epic.
Damn, Goku.
But isn't he like busy in China or whatever?
That would have been the most, I think that actually would have been the most, like, not logical, but you know what I mean? Like, possible one.
Best fitting guess.
Yeah. People in the comments saying, like, oh, we want Mr. Girl.
I reached out to Mr. Girl. He says, like, are you kidding me? No, it's that crazy guy that's not on the picture. I'm like, bet.
You did not. I do not believe you.
He groaned a little bit. Harry. You underestimate dedication.
Anyway.
Hey, man, I just like, I don't even know at this point. Like, at this point, we're just going to have to get Bryce Heroism or something. Like,
let's
just like somebody normal.
Somebody normal.
Yeah. My suspicion, it either might be. Just like all of our friends at the same time, just Fruit Masas.
Oh no!
To close this year off, or like I have two more people I want to ask our team to reach out.
Let's get Nier on the podcast.
Stop it! We already had him. We already had him.
Ego tell us to kill ourselves.
Let's go. We're going to be buried 6 feet under and have our family Kevin triggerable trauma.
I hope your family gets trauma.
You guys are fucking mean and evil.
Nier.
Oh my god. Nier is a fucking legend. I don't know how he keeps coming up with this truly despicable
shit. Honestly, that shit was such a cold read. Yeah. If somebody said that to me in the Discord server, I would uninstall.
Yeah. No, I will never forget. I'll never forget.
Your family never remembers you. Whoa!
I will never forget. The funniest shit he's ever said on the server is... It was when he was pissed off at people at the server. And he just goes... I hate this server sometimes. Little gay people on my phone getting me mad.
Oh my god.
That's you guys whenever I text in the group chat. Hey guys, we need to get this done. Oh my god, this gay man in my phone.
Like, shut the fuck up.
Oh my fucking god.
We
love
you,
Nier.
Can always get Jason's dad on the podcast.
Can we get your father?
What?
What?
Son, I'm not dead. Why would you say
that? Oh, my,
that?
Satan. Right. My bad.
Coming out
oh, shit, bro. No fucking way.
Not,
oh, my
did
God.
Not make a connection.
I'm glad no one acknowledged what
said. It got so bad so quick. Holy Calm, shit. Son.
I'm sure Nier can reach out to my dad.
Oh, fuck.
Out of here.
Oh my god.
What the fuck?
What's going on today, bro?
Shit. Oh, we have fun here, boys.
No, honestly, this is just brainstorm right now. Like, because, like, I'm gonna tell you. Oh, okay, you'll be surprised. We'll all name one, and we'll argue why that person should deserve a space on our podcast.
Okay.
Oh.
So my number one is Big Kuza. It's a dude on TikTok.
Okay. No, you're done. You're done. You are not coming in here and saying some random nigga that probably doesn't exist. There's no way. Nah, there's no way there's someone on the fucking planet who would name themselves Big Kuza. You are gaslighting me right now. There's no fucking way that someone exists. Jason, I would have accepted anything else other than that name. That sounds like the most made up shit I've ever heard.
Oh, I bet it's all the fucking these nuts in your mouth joke.
I especially love the fact that he said it so like he was set on it. Like, that was his answer. That was his answer, bro.
It's a real guy, I promise.
Why?
There's no
Wait, you guys,
fucking
it's,
way.
He's on TikTok. You never seen the fucking. I would rather see it on a sidewalk. And
oh
eat a
my
shit
fucking
with a bucket
god!
Of biscuit.
You mean that big fat nigga?
Yeah.
Oh my god! I know.
He's actually
him.
A rapper, and his shit is fire. Like, I listen to his shit; it's pretty fire. It would be fun to have god. Him. And he like makes like that's his genre of content. He kind of brought it to TikTok. So I wanna chat with him.
Ain't no
a couple
fucking
suggestions,
way.
And I need you to hear them all out before you say anything.
Okay.
We got Gus Johnson.
Okay.
Classic
we got
choice.
Mr. Girl.
Classic
of
choice.
We got R. Kelly.
Classic choice.
We have O.J. Simpson.
Oh, holy
classic
shit.
Classic choice.
Bill Cosby.
Loose.
Classic
and
choice.
And last but not least, obviously, Chris Brown.
Never
Let's go.
Never him. Never him.
I think there's a motif here.
Yeah, there seems to be a kind of connection between all these
about.
People.
These are just respectable artists. That
starts with Miss, ends with Ajin.
Because their careers were big. Mrs. A.
Hey, that was a bad.
No,
was
I think
bad.
It was referring to all the women that were abused.
Oh my god.
Their careers might have been misses, but their punches sure landed.
Oh my god!
Bro, hey, Gus Johnson never beat a woman, I don't think. I don't know the guy, maybe.
Speaking of abusing women, like, did you ever fucking heard a court test? Like,
you can do it.
I thought you were gonna say you ever abused women. I was like,
no,
what?
Like, no funny shit. I can't joke about like Chris Brown and Rihanna after I read the court statement.
Yeah, I heard it. I heard
oh,
it.
No,
that shit was evil.
Report.
That shit was evil.
I can't, man. Like,
yeah, it's fucked
I
up.
Can't. That and shit after seeing this video, I don't think I can anymore. Like, this shit is...
Yeah, Chris Brown, big bad.
Yeah. I still don't get how... Take. I still don't get how he still gets, like, work, you know?
I hate when people get upset when I get upset that he's still famous.
No, it's completely understandable. Who is getting upset that you're upset
well,
that he's famous?
Well, there were times over the past, like, oh, I hate Chris Brown, and you guys were like, you're not, you're jumping on the bandwagon, it already exists,
what?
Like, get over it. Just like, hang on, I think it's justified.
Are you calling us Chris Brown sympathizers?
No. What you said is like,
boy,
God,
if you don't
like,
shut it, the fuck up.
No. What you guys said was that it's not original to hate Chris Brown, basically. So I should just shut the
we
fuck
never,
up.
We never
when
said
did
this.
I say that?
Bad
this to hate
happened.
Chris
this
Brown.
This was Fruit Part 2, I think.
I'm gonna gaslight the
fuck
out of
you.
Watch
this. Go pull that up.
Wait, guys. I'm gonna gaslight the fuck out of him. Watch this. This never happened.
Okay. Yeah. What are you gonna say?
This
that
never
Jake,
happened,
Jacob.
It never happened.
Jason was supposed to be a temporary guest. He should just leave.
Yo, okay. He's not okay. Wrong. He started as a fucking guest. I remember that.
And I just overstayed my welcome for 3 years.
He just hasn't left.
He just like. Like fucking what's his face? Elon Musk was just like, oh, like Jason's gonna be there too. I'm like, no.
No, thank
he's
you.
He's just like kinda like hanging around, but he didn't like get the memo. He's busy with R. Grimes or whatever the fuck her name
R.
was.
R. Grimes.
When he got divorced.
You're texting
Rick,
him, yo,
did
Elon,
you say
are you
R. Grimes because of Rick Grimes from Walking Dead?
No, his ex-wife's name was like Grimes or some shit.
But no, yeah, no way. Up. There's no connection to that.
Wait. What was her name?
Grimes. Yeah.
Grimes. Yeah. It was
yeah,
just Grimes.
It's an artist.
Yeah, but he said R. Grimes. There's no way. There's not a connection to Walking Dead. There. There's
yeah,
no
yeah.
way.
Like, Jacob's like texting Elon like by episode 20. He's like, are you gonna ever pick him back up? Because Jason was here a while. Like, can we just put him on a supply ship, like, on the way back? He's like, no, don't do this.
On the Michael Drake episode, Jason was supposed to leave back on the spaceship with Elon. He just, like, didn't. I don't know what happened there.
Let's get Elon on the podcast.
The oh, well, scary thing, too, honestly, is he didn't pick Michael Drake back up. He's just in space somewhere.
Yo. We left Michael Drake just drifting.
he's just out and about. I don't know, man.
Well, actually, I think we could. It would be nice to have Michael Drake on episode 100. You know what? Worst comes to worst. You know, I don't think... Do you not agree?
No, I didn't hear you, honestly. I'm not going to lie to you.
Oh, okay. Well, I think you should have Michael Drake for episode 100.
I'd rather
have Mr. Girl.
I'd rather have Mr. Girl, too, honestly.
Oh, okay. Well,
It has nothing to do with his character. It's just Mr. Girl. Like,
I feel like the fucking... I honestly think round three, Mr. Girl...
Hat trick
would be perfect for episode 100. I actually think that.
Plan C then.
I think the craziest thing about it would be like if we're like capable of convincing him to come back on the podcast, that alone would be so impressive. He hates Jason.
He doesn't hate me, he's scared of me.
I'm surprised he hasn't made like one of his diss tracks.
Mr. Girl was sending us texts to Austin. Can I please just have Jason's audio quiz just to make sure I'm not my identity is not compromised, because he said some crazy things on the podcast.
He wanted just Jason's
I actually dare you, Jason, after this episode to then go on our group Twitter and at Mr. Girl and be like, round three, let's do this.
Dude, I'll do it. I don't care.
At him and be like, round three, let's go, bro.
Round three, question mark.
All right, you know what?
Let's go!
At this point, we just gotta exit.
I wonder if
he's
got us blocked or something.
Let's see.
Honor
let's see this. If I can't
still.
Book anyone crazy...
Well, he is crazy.
If like, okay, well, this is our fallback, okay?
Mm-hmm.
If anything, episode 101 will be with Mr.
can we get McJuggernuggets' ex-girlfriend on the podcast?
What is
McJuggernuggets won't respond to me.
Honestly, hold on. I want to talk about Mr. Juggernuggets, all right? Let me talk about this nigga. Let me talk about this fucking nigga. What the fuck is going on with this fucking idiot? Like,
what
honestly.
Do you mean exactly?
What the fuck is going on with this platform, StoryFire?
Bro, that was so crazy. We're shutting it down. Psych, we're not. Actually, give us money now.
Actually, we're going to sell it to this other guy. He's running the company. Oh, wait, I just got announced as the CEO. What is going on over there?
Honestly, I don't even fucking know.
Mark Zuckerberg thought he had... actually, he's pretty similar to Austin McGroom. Oh, no.
Oh no. CEO of StoryFire
now.
Fucking,
we were doing so good.
You did that on purpose. Don't fucking lie to me.
No, honestly not. Honestly not. Honestly. Okay. Fuck, I can't believe I'm the culprit of the grooming.
Twice in a row.
Guys, add it to the checklist. It's too late now.
My Juggernaut just really thought he had way too much clout. Like, he thought he had way more clout than he really had.
That's just weird.
Yeah, I'm a hater.
I just found the weirdest thing I've ever seen on Twitter.
Tell us about it.
And this is this. Okay, so this isn't going to make any sense, but this, I'm sorry, this has to be a fucking topic. So I don't know if you guys ever heard of Angry Grandpa.
Yeah.
You know, Pickle Boy.
He died, right? Dead.
Well, Angry Grandpa died, yes. But the channel was always run by his son, Pickle Boy, Michael.
Yeah, that dude is, I don't know.
He's something. Him and his, I think, girlfriend still, Bridget, they had a kid. They had a daughter a year or two ago, Mia. Well, I'm just scrolling on Twitter right now. And I just see this Twitter account, Mia Nicole Green, Michael Robert Charles Green. It's a fucking fan page for the daughter.
I can't.
Someone made a fan page for a 2-year-old girl.
Touch grass.
I'm disgusted.
Touch grass.
Wait. Who's it run by? It's not, because it's followed by no one I'm following, which means it's not made by Pickle Boy. Otherwise, he'd follow the account, right?
So it's just weird.
It's just disgusting. It's like, what are you doing?
But Aaron... Austin, what are your dream guests for episode 100 then?
Probably Pickle Boy's daughter.
You okay?
I'm sorry.
Is your name Austin or Aerie?
Are you okay?
I'm sorry.
Are you okay?
I'm sorry.
I
might be dyslexic, but Austin or Aerie does not rhyme or doesn't even come close to Jacob.
That's a little bit. It's Erica Cub or Austin Cub.
What?
I think I just had a stroke.
We got new suffixes. What's going on?
I'm putting chlorine in your G Fuel.
Hold on, Jacob. That's a whole new suffix to my name. What's going on here?
Eric Cub.
See, now, when you translate it through every language on Google Translate,
it comes back.
Anyways,
to Eric Cub.
My dream guest for episode 100. Would probably be Travis Scott.
Let's fucking go!
I should have added him to my list.
Can we have a more realistic one, please?
Little Nas X.
Santa Claus.
All right.
What the fuck? What's wrong with you? Can we get Eddie Burback on the podcast?
Oh my god. No.
He's not verified on Twitter, so he's not that popular.
I wanna say my dream guest. My dream guest.
Actually, really quick, mine would be Mimulus.
Ooh, that's not bad.
That's, how doable is that?
I don't know.
How doable you not?
Eddie Burback might be doable. We should actually try.
I'll ask our producer to email Mimulus. I'll tell him to be like, hey, you know what'd be funny? If you came on this podcast with
we tried getting Leafy on. Why don't you come on in this place?
If he actually comes on, I want to talk about how his fucking podcast died. Fucking bitch.
Ironically. Just come on this shit ironically.
Yeah. It would be so ironic.
Dude, he's in Cali right now. Jacob, go kidnap him or something.
What the fuck?
I'm sorry?
What's up, guys? Welcome to Cosmicast. We're holding Mimulus hostage. So, Mimulus, how are you doing?
Let's go.
Oh, no, sorry, you got a struggle in British.
Wait. Can we actually try for Eddie Burback?
Oh, this is quite a predicament.
I don't know what I could do to get into this one.
Oh, fuck me, man.
I've got myself in quite a pickle.
Pickle, isn't it?
You can tell 7K to
I want to try.
We will try Eddie Burback. Holy fuck.
But I do want to say, if we try for Eddie Burback, we have to like dance around like talking about Gus.
Oh god!
Like, I'm a big fan of your podcast.
I'm bringing him up in the first 5 minutes, man.
No, you're not gonna embarrass me against my dream guest.
And he's like, you're done. You're done.
You're done. He just disconnects, and he's like, he emails us, gotta get Jason's audio to make sure.
God, that's when I knew I was a real menace, when he only asked for my audio. He didn't even ask for anybody else. He's like, I need Jason's audio.
I need Jason's audio.
Harry, who's your dream guest?
My dream guest is the author of this specific tweet. Nick Sells keep having this weird fantasy of women not wanting them because they're too nice. When in actuality, it's because they're an asshole. I need you to fucking understand the whiplash I got at work today when this popped up on my feed. The amount of whiplash that occurred when I saw this tweet.
Harry, could you please say that first word again?
Of course. Of course, my dear Austin. Of course I'll read it again. Nig cells.
Can I say that?
No! What the fuck do you mean? Can you say that?
He gave it a shot.
He really tried it, bro!
And you missed 100% of the shots you gotta take. Chris Brown 2020.
Oh no.
That's it, I'm done.
Oh, my head hurts. Oh my God, my head hurts.
I figured if I could like manage to get holy a girlfriend shit this year, maybe I could manage to let you say yes to what I just asked you.
Oh my fucking God. No.
Hey, can we get Ray William Johnson on the podcast? I want to talk about only your favorite Martian.
I would love to talk about your favorite Martian with him. I need him to explain what was going on in his coke addicted mind when he made some of these songs. Like
transphobic techno, you mean?
Like, what's wrong with this nigga? Like, honestly, you know the
wait,
one,
Austin. Austin,
our plan C could be Jacob's girlfriend, I believe.
I'm down for that.
I'm down to do that.
I don't know if she is. Can we lower? Lower my voice like Satan right now when I sing this, okay, Austin?
Who's got a penis? Bitch got a penis. Who's got a penis? Bitch got a penis.
We gotta talk
Jason,
about that
if
song
you weren't here, we're talking about Ray William Johnson and his
No, I was here the whole
okay,
time.
Good.
I just slammed my door for comedic effect.
Of course.
So can we talk about that song only?
No. I need him to explain several songs. You know the one that I heard recently, Stalking Your Mom. What the fuck?
Wait, no, Stalking Your Mom is a cover. It's not even the original, dude.
Are you fucking someone else made that song?
Yeah. Have you heard of the rapper named Wax? He's not that popular anymore, but he made that song.
I've never heard of a nigga. Who the fuck names themselves Wax?
Wax on.
I don't know.
Wax on,
can we talk about
on
the stereotype song?
I've not heard the stereotype song. You want to sing
oh
it?
Oh my
me?
God, you gotta hear the
that
stereotype
one is
song.
Definitely racist. I can already tell.
Oh yeah, it's racist.
Oh my
it's
God.
It's without a doubt racist. Dude, I've been going back through old Eagles 3 episodes. Like, he says the N-word more than once.
Isn't he a black man? Or am I crazy?
No.
Ray William Johnson?
Yeah, what is he?
Yeah, he's not black.
I thought he had some black in him.
I don't know what he is, but he's
what
not
is Ray
black
William Johnson? He's got tint to his skin. What the fuck are you talking about?
He's not. Okay, I'm looking up.
I'm not saying he's fully black. I'm not saying he's fully black, but he's got some melanin in there.
What
he
race?
Got like Jacob's level of melanin. Like in the sun, you can kind of make out a little bit of darkness.
Hold on.
I can't say it, though.
Ray William Johnson.
Ethnicity. Here we go. Wait. Where is it? I don't want words. I just want facts.
Oh, this facts is an article? I'm not reading this shit.
This isn't. It's imperative to our podcast.
We must. We can't spread misinformation online.
That's all I do, baby.
Let's go.
Oh my fucking
did you know that
God
Ray William Johnson committed vehicle manslaughter?
Did he really?
Yeah, in 2007.
Why did he do that?
I don't know. We can ask him if he could get him on.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Hey, Ray William Johnson.
Where were you on the night of?
Oh, God.
This article is specifically saying right now, Ray William Johnson is not having an affair with anyone presently.
What the fuck? What is going what on?
Rest in peace. Couldn't
know
be me.
Where's his ethnicity? I need it. Okay, wait.
Okay, I think he found it, but I already found it, but you can say
his nationality is American and his ethnicity is mixed English, German, and Scottish.
Yeah, he's white.
This has this white nigga got no black in him. What the fuck?
But here's the thing, though. He has a little tint to his skin, like you said. But he's like me. Like, yeah,
it's called
N-word.
A tan.
Bro.
Yeah.
He was gripping on for dear life just to be able to say the N-word. God damn.
Did people just let it slide back then?
Yeah.
Yeah, like, dude, that was the internet back then. That was the internet back then. Yeah, no one fucking cared.
Nobody cared.
No one cared.
All right, let's do some Q&A, baby.
I want to pull up this one clip of Ray William Johnson.
Well, I don't want to. I'm sorry.
But I want to. Don't you care about my feelings?
No.
What's your go-to order at McDonald's? The W man asks.
Two McDoubles, a large fry, and a large soda.
Damn, bro, you eating?
Shut the fuck up.
He sounded mad, man. He sounded so mad.
Why not just one burger?
Because I'm big enough.
Is like a Big Mac is small for you?
It's not a Big Mac. It's a McDouble, idiot.
No, that's what I'm saying. That's what I'm saying. Just get a bigger burger.
I don't want a Big Mac.
I'm not going to lie. The Big Mac is the worst burger ever created. It tastes awful.
I don't fuck
like, how do
Big
you
Mac
go
anymore.
Into McDonald's and order a fucking Big Mac? It is slathered in this disgusting-ass sauce that is probably mayo and cum, and it tastes awful. I don't get how you do it. And it's covered in lettuce. Just absolutely destroyed with lettuce.
It's fucking lettuce.
It.
I'll probably give you like E. coli as well.
I fucking hate the Big Mac. Whoever created it deserves to die.
My go-to is just like nuggets and a McFlurry. Like, that's the only edible thing in McDonald's. If you think otherwise, I don't care.
I honestly, I've been ordering the same thing. Like, I haven't gone to McDonald's in a little bit, but I kind of order the same thing. It's two McDoubles.
Damn,
and
just
a large
you're eating
fry.
Too, huh? Sorry.
Yeah, I'm eating. I always work it off. I always work it off.
No, I'm just like, why McDoubles? I don't know.
Jason eats vegetables all day, so he pretends he's like more healthy than us.
Yeah, what? I don't eat vegetables when you beat vegetable allegations.
My nigga, that's the minimum I have to eat from there in order to fill myself up. Like, literally, if I eat any less, I will not fill
McDoubles?
Myself up. Yeah, two McDoubles and a large fry. That's it.
Word,
and then
word,
I'm full.
Word. No drink? No bev?
No. I don't get it. No, I just drink water.
Oh, okay.
Wait,
That's the best.
Do you get the Optimus Prime order?
That's Burger King. Get your Transformers lore right.
I want to get the callback. Fuck you.
Get to stretch a little bit
Jason
for that one.
Such an asshole.
Yeah, you want me to do it anyway?
Yeah, I do.
Let me get a Whopper. No cheese, no onion.
It's like, sir, this is the McDonald's. We don't do the Whopper here.
Fucking blows up the gun. Blows up the McDonald's.
He just steps on it. It's a fucking 20 fucking foot car.
Autobots, roll out.
Autobots, we took the wrong exit.
They just start fucking kicking the McDonald's.
We took the wrong exit. We took the wrong exit.
The fucking Decepticon see it and is like, holy shit. What the fuck? Optimus Prime.
We took exit 71A. We should have waited for 71B.
Oh my god.
Anyways, my go-to order is...
Yo, the Decepticons ask for directions.
Anyways...
Fucking hell.
Autobots, I'm confused by the LA highway system.
Who isn't?
Who the fuck has the map?
Okay, Austin, what's your
go-to? I'm the map, Bob, the map!
Oh my god, shut the fuck up! Shut up!
It's the modern day doors and GPS. I'm GPS, GPS!
Oh my god, just shut up, man.
I think I would blow my brains out if that happened in real life. Holy shit. That sounds awful.
Was that
awful.
The live action one with Ariane? Ariel?
No, it turns out that she was fucking hallucinating the entire time. So they're not real. Yeah, dude, I'm not kidding. She was actually hallucinating the entire time. She was high.
Are you going to let Austin say his answer? Or?
Hey, Austin, go ahead, bud.
I already said it. You missed
it. What was
say it again, though.
It was a mango pineapple smoothie.
That's it?
That's a good one. Oh, an iced coffee. Throw the iced coffee in my shit. Throw the iced coffee. Real gay shit.
Yeah, instead of recording the podcast, he goes to McDonald's.
I haven't had a mango. I've never had that before. Is it really good?
The banana strawberry
one's really
better,
good.
Buddy.
You know it's serious when he busts out the buddy.
I think if I'm really feeling fruity, I would get like a, I would get a milkshake. I'd get a strawberry milkshake from there.
Wait, hold on. I want to double back for a second. Jacob, did you shame me for eating vegetables? You fucking dork.
I knew he was going to bring that back up.
He's a fucking liberal pussy. I said liberal.
Sorry, Jacob, you cannot say liberal. There's something very wrong about you saying it.
Yeah, I fucking got a motherfucking liberal on the podcast. You stupid liberals
maintaining a nutritious, well-rounded diet.
Liberal. I only eat oil. You're ruining up my country.
Oh, God.
You liberals and your avocado toast.
Get your Wyoming ass out of here. Dude, you're in Wyoming. You're supposed to be Republican, you fucking idiot.
Oh, God. Fucking liberals. It really liberals did shock.
And their vegetables.
It truly did shock me when I found out that liberals are just as bad as conservatives. It's crazy.
Really?
Obviously. Yeah. No, I heard some fuck shit coming out from
liberals. Bro, honestly, like, I refuse to believe that America is ready for a change or there's any hope for our country when... First of all, KKK is not outlawed. And second of all, the Federal Reserve Bank, or whatever the name is a private company.
Mm-hmm. I don't understand.
The KKK or the KKK?
Biden has been in office for how many months now? And KKK is still not a terrorist group? I don't know.
Huh? Wasn't it already labeled a terrorist group?
Was it? Am I stupid?
Maybe. I thought they were and also Antifa were at the same time.
Oh, they got a double kill, bitch. They got both sides.
Next question. I think this was answered before, but what was the closest you guys ever came to fully disbanding the podcast, and what caused it?
Are we really going to tell? Are we really going to tell?
Because for now, we will say that it was like it, if you like look at my blog entries, I think when I wrote that was like September 2019. Then that was like our big break. Huh? And then the closest, we went in really hard, like,
okay,
2020
big,
early.
I thought you meant big break as in when we started blowing up.
No, big break is like big pause of like not
long
making
break.
Yeah.
Gotcha.
That was a good time.
When we didn't do the podcast.
Yeah. And work. I was like every single week, when are we going to record?
I needed that break. You know what? I need another break. Can we just like not record?
It's not a designated terrorist organization.
7 weeks.
Which one?
Wait, what?
The KKK.
Well, yeah, no. Wait. Excuse me. No, I don't want to talk about the KKK anymore.
Yeah, me either. Yeah, so that was, and you know, maybe like one day we'll tell you. You will see. After the episode 100, we'll tell you for sure when was the closest time.
Oh, my fucking God.
Yeah, I mean, it's true. Like, we can't tell them now. We don't know yet.
No, that's not exactly what I mean. I'm on Twitter right now. Don't be mad at me. But
are you seriously on Twitter while we're recording the podcast?
Yes.
Are you serious?
And we're doing Q&A. Like, we don't need extra research.
Listen, my niggas. Fucking Dr. Umar is apparently on Twitter right now because hashtag interracial dating is trending.
Okay.
Oh, my God. It's a spaces chat. Is dating interracially as a black person wrong? Hashtag interracial dating. Oh, my fucking God.
That should be our guest on episode 100.
Oh, my God. It should.
No fucking way.
Yo, hold on.
What's going on, buddy?
I might be able to. Hold on. You know what? Let me just write this down.
What are you doing? What are you
ask
doing?
A certain doctor.
No fucking way.
Oh,
he is
no.
not doing it.
I don't want to talk
He's
to him.
He's a bum. He's not doing it.
Would you pass on the opportunity if he said yes?
I wouldn't. I fucking wouldn't, but he's not doing it.
All right.
I would not pass.
Right.
I would not pass on
it. I'll ask our team to reach out and we'll see what we can do.
Let's try it.
So I love saying our team is just one guy.
Just this one nigga.
I hate you in this server with a deep passion. I want to die, and Thaddeus, you make me dread coming here every single day. But this is the only feeling of serotonin I get, so fuck. This is not a question, man.
That is not a question. Who pinned this? Who the fuck pinned this?
When is the intense Fortnite gameplay coming? I want to see my favorite cosmic squad up and crack 90s.
We might actually do that. No bullshit.
It could be kind of fun, though. Wait, whose skin are you buying?
Whose skin are you buying?
I'm getting that Naruto skin, please.
I'm getting Morty.
Oh, God.
Morty.
I got to roll with the Mandalorian.
Sans.
There's no fucking sands, idiot.
Well, there's a skull hack trooper. Him in the game.
Just wait like a couple of months. They'll get him.
Just wait a couple
oh,
months.
God. I might actually cry if I see fucking sands building the Taj Mahal.
Sands is not dead yet, guys. He's coming
oh,
back.
Oh, God.
Sands is not dead.
Bro, you're hiding.
You guys think
bro,
sands could.
Bro, you're hiding in
you
a bush.
Think sands could come.
You're hiding in a.
You're hiding in the bush, just megalovania approaches you.
No. You're hiding in a bush. You're. And I want to circle back to what the fuck
nope,
Jacob just said.
What, nope.
What is wrong with you? Like, honestly, what is wrong with you as a human being for you to say shit like that? Like, are you okay? I know you have a girlfriend now and you're constantly horny now. Like, control yourself, please. You're a grown ass man. Thank you.
I'm a grown ass woman.
Yeah, let's satisfy Jacob's horniness and also make him problematic with his girlfriend. Here's a Uh-oh. Question for y'all. If you had a chance to fuck any celebrity with guaranteed protection, like you can do it raw and never be able to talk to your friends, can make new friends. So basically, dude's saying like you can get away with fucking any celebrity consensually. Who would it be, I guess?
I'm a celebrity, so I'd fuck myself.
Okay. All
right. You're the least interesting person on the
podcast. This is going to this requires a bit of thinking. I'd fuck Beyonce.
Amari!
I'd have raw, vigorous, rough, jackhammer style sex with Beyonce. Okay. I'd fuck the shit out of Beyonce. Okay. Oh my God. I'd have her creaming. Squirt. Oh my God, she's throwing shit at me. Amari's throwing shit at me. I'd have her creaming.
I got you
squirting.
Amari.
I heard the TV remote land on your forehead.
I'd have her screaming. Squirting.
I heard the dish
network
remote hit Ari in the back of the head.
That shit will grip. Amari, don't throw that. That shit will grip on my dick.
Amari throws a whole air conditioning unit.
Oh my God.
Oh God. She threw a water
bottle.
You
go, girl boss. You go.
You should throw Ari into the TV.
Ah, she's not done. I'm done. I won't talk about Beyonce.
I agree with Amari. I feel like this answer should only be for Jason.
You wouldn't fuck Beyonce?
No.
Damn. Racist.
Amari said no.
What? It's racist? True. Are you serious right now, dude?
Yeah.
She said she would do Rihanna, though.
I don't know. I actually don't have anybody in mind. I honestly don't. Like, maybe Drake.
Gary V.
I just gotta know some things.
No, and don't, like, don't
even,
do that.
Even, I hate that answer.
Even like, instead, I would instead have dinner with him.
Okay.
Oh my God.
Dinner with Jay-Z. I would take Jay-Z, and instead of fucking, I'll take him to dinner.
Drake says, I love my bed and my mom, so that's it. Like that, right? That guy.
And Jay-Z's like, you could have fucked Beyonce, man. Should have taken the 500K. Hey, let's ruin this for everybody. What's your opinion on Kyle Rittenhouse case?
Oh, let's go. I want to talk about this.
Do we have to?
I want to talk about this.
What's up, guys? What's wrong?
Do we really have to?
We were talking about fucking women getting being. We were talking about women.
Tried to ruin it for me. But I still don't know every single detail about it, and I don't
want
to know about it.
Make no fucking sense to me. We were talking about women getting fucking beaten a second ago.
Yes, because I knew every single detail of that case. I don't know every single detail of this one. I almost made it through a social controversy without knowing every single detail.
Oh my Lord. Can we still talk about it anyway?
No.
Yes.
Yeah, let's do it.
Let's talk about it. You don't have to say
anything. I do not consent.
You don't have to
say
anything.
You are literally raping me with this information.
You don't have to say anything. You don't even have to fucking listen to this. I want to talk about this. I want to say some words.
You should have laughed.
Should have what?
Laughed.
Why would I laugh?
That's a good question.
Okay, here we go. I'm going to talk, all right? Okay, so the Kyle Rittenhouse case, I think it was very obvious, like even going into the case, that Kyle Rittenhouse was going to get off.
Everybody who's been paying attention, not guilty. You should have known. Yeah. Right.
You should have
jumped.
But the entire case, watching that unfold, was both one of the most entertaining shits I've ever seen in my life and also the most sad. Dog. It was truly sad watching it, but also the funniest shit. Why would you run? Why? What was so urgent? Yeah. There was a fire.
So why would you run from to the fire? What was so urgent?
I don't fucking understand this. Whoever that prosecutor is.
Dog. People were saying like the persecution is paid off as well. They just did this for fun. They all knew he's gonna get acquitted, so they just all did it for fun. They were like having fun the whole time.
A theory going around was that he was trying to purposely get a mistrial so they could start all over again. But
there was no need for that, man. It was so crazy watching that. Like honestly, it was so insane the whole time. And like obviously, like the judge and whatever. And yeah, why does it feel like in this country everything is just seems like a reality TV thing?
Yeah,
like, whether it's elections or these trials, like it's so stupid.
It's ridiculous, honestly.
And people claiming like, "Whoa, good thing he killed those people. Look at the left defending the lives of like child molesters." I agree. Like it's like I don't have sympathy for like the people he killed because there's criminals, but like it still doesn't justify him shooting at a crowd because.
I thought the whole thing was that it wasn't at a crowd. It was at the people attacking him. I thought that was one of the big consensus.
Exactly that. Well, it doesn't justify him like showing up to protest with a rifle either way.
Yeah, I don't think so. I don't think
because like what you're telling me, he pulled up his criminal background on everyone who was attacking him. Like, oh well, this guy. Let me.
I truly don't think that Kyle Rittenhouse should have been there with a gun.
There's no need for him to be there.
I don't think those people should have attacked him at all. I don't think this should have happened at all. Nothing should have happened here. I truly think nothing should have happened here.
The dudes who attacked him were also like anarchists and like just like people who were like also
criminals. They were literally rioting.
Like, not the actual protesters. Like the whole case is fucked up because
and one was like an active like pedophile.
Yeah.
Five time offending pedophile.
But like you know how bullets are. You know it's a stray bullet, then they hits the protester behind the pedophile. You know what I mean? Like, why are you there defending a Walmart? Like it's not.
He should have never
lined up to me the fact that he was there. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm. He's a 17-year-old kid and he was just really stupid. Is all.
I'm recording.
Why are you yelling?
Because they always do this. Anyway, I truly think that this case truly showed
me.
Wait,
Jacob. I don't think you can justify that though. He's stupid at 17. Like, I at 17, anybody has a.
I don't think someone like a normal human being at 17 would go to a literal riot with a gun.
Let me go be a vigilante.
Yeah, I don't think that would happen.
Or like a Walmart, or like what was it? Like a Target on fire? Like, ooh, I'm gonna.
I have several thoughts about this. I think truly that this case truly shows the power of white privilege. You know, like we all know that white privilege is still strong, but this shows even the biggest doubters that it's still going on even stronger. You know,
oh for sure.
Like, and also I think this would have been such a. I'm just glad. I'm sorry to say this. I'm just glad not a single black person was shot. Like, or
but you can say that. You can say that.
Yeah, because I'm just thinking, like, first off, it would be a fucking tragedy if that happened. It would be a tragedy. Good thing we only had white pedophiles. That's good. That's a joke. I'm not being serious.
But like, honestly, like, okay, these were like abusers and pedophiles. But like one of the dude, they portraying him is like he was he was under the influence with a gun. So like, I thought open carry was cool.
Mm. Oh, no. They actually revealed that the dude who was pointing a gun at, well, that was the reveal that he was actually pointing his gun at him at Kyle.
Okay.
Yeah. And like actively like, you know, threatening him. Mm. That was actually one of the biggest,
so that's why he won self-defense.
Yeah. Yeah. That's exactly what they banked on.
Yeah.
Yeah. This entire case was very fucked.
I'm honestly happy none of the protesters got shot.
I'm glad it was only like the people who are using it for their own causes.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I don't want people dying, but I'm not sad that a pedophile got shot.
Yeah, that's my thought about it. I'm not sad. I don't wish death on people.
And oh my god,
at all. But
my final thoughts on this: the celebrities on Twitter, fucking
Bro, who's paying y'all to do this?
No fucking way. Mark Ruffalo? Pedro Pascal, bro?
Mark, what did Mark tweet?
He tweet. Hold on. Oh my God, I gotta read this. I hope he hasn't deleted
it yet. Mark is always funny on his...
Here we go. Hold on. This was actually worse than the Pedro Pascal one. Please tell me he didn't delete it. Please tell me he didn't delete it. Oh,
just paraphrase it.
Okay. I found it. We come together to mourn the lives lost to the same racist system that devalues black lives and devalued the lives of Anthony and JoJo. He literally gave one of the fucking attackers a cute nickname, JoJo. And guess what? That was the fucking pedophile.
It's the right words. It's not the right place to say them. It's so, man. It's foul.
Fucked up, man.
It's foul. It's crazy how... I agree with you. I'm glad none of the black people got shot. None of the protesters got shot. Because, you know, that would have been just such an unnecessary loss.
Damn, all these guys have some fucked up shit in their past, too. Goddamn.
Yeah. Mark Ruffalo is so crazy. Like, remember, it was like during the, like, when the Palestine thing was at its
peak. Oh, yeah.
He was like, yeah, I remember that. Was like, you know, like, free power to the people, power to all the people, or something like that. And then he deleted it and he was like, well, it's a complex, multifaceted issue. Just don't say shit.
You know, someone came down and was like, hey, Mark, come on. We can't take a strong
stand. Disney just called. Yeah. Cut this shit. You want another Hulk? Delete that shit.
Delete it. Oh my God. That is hilarious. Anyway, yeah, that's our little thoughts about the Kyle Rittenhouse case. I hope you guys enjoyed this episode.
Can we get Kyle Rittenhouse on the podcast? Oh.
Hit him up right now.
No, what the fuck? No.
Where's his management team?
Dude's fucking partying with Proud Boys. I don't want
to. Yo, I've never seen someone get slingshotted into conservatism faster than that kid.
Bro,
he's going to be
I'm
a hardcore
you, like,
conservative.
He, like, in 10 years, this dude's like in Congress, I promise you.
For sure.
Dude is in Congress in like 10, 20 years.
Hey, Senator, remember when he shot those three people with the fucking AR-15?
He's going to be saying the hard R by next week, bro. Okay. Hard R by next week. Thanks for the watching, people.
See, hey, wait. Oh, okay. I want to.
Oh, wait.
Close
you have
on a lighter
no,
note a little bit.
Oh, yeah. Go ahead. No.
Yeah. Too it late. Says. Oh, you stopped recording?
Do we have to clap thing again? Buddy?
Did you stop recording?
Who are you talking to?
You,
bud.
Because you said too late.
Oh, no. I meant too late. I already feel violated.